Afternoon, my dear students. Last class we have seen digestion in humans, right? Today we will see digestion in grass eating animals. So have you observed some buffaloes, cows are eating continuously? Every time you can see they are chewing. What they are chewing this much? So whenever they are seeing the grass, maybe from morning till 2 or 3 hours they will eat the grass. And they will store in the place in the intestine that is known as the rumen, and it will be partially digested, half digested, and that is known as the cud. And slowly again it will come to the mouth, and again it will chew and it will digest properly. So today we are going to learn about digestion in grass eating animals. Okay, so you can see here. So digestion in grass eating animals. So when cow, buffaloes and other grass eating animals are eating, grazing, during grazing, when they are eating the grass, first they will cut it and they will take it. Okay, then this will be stored in a part in the intestine that is known as the rumen. That is known as the rumen, R-U-M-E-N, rumen. Okay, so that will be partially digested. Just it will cut it and full digestion will not be there. It will be partially, half digestion will be over, and that condition is known as the curd. C-U-D, curd. Okay, again it will take to the mouth. Okay, so then slowly it will digest. So we can see every time the cow will chew, that is known as the, this process is known as the rumination. So this process of taking the food and storing in the rumen, again it will take the food to the mouth and it will chew till it digested. That process is known as the rumination. R-U-M-I-N-A-T-I-O-N. Okay, that process is known as the rumination. So these animals are known as the ruminants. Okay, so these animals are known as the ruminants. Okay, once again I will tell. So when the animals are taking the, when they are grazing on the field, on the grass, they will cut it and store in a place, that is the rumen. That will store in a place in the intestine that is known as the rumen. That partially digested food is known as the curd. After that again the food will take to the mouth. Okay, and it will do slowly, it will chew it again and digestion will take place. First step of digestion will take place. So just when the, in the case of animals like ruminants, animals like cattle and deer, usually what will be the food present in the grass? The grass contain a tissue that is known as the cellulose. Okay, cellulose is little hard substance, it is not very easy to digest. So it will take, if you take the intestine, if you see the intestine of these herbivores and human beings, it will be more long compared to the human beings. Cattle and deer's intestine will be too lengthy compared to the human beings, because the cellulose is little hard to digest. So it will take time to digest. Okay, so the cellulose, this cattle and deer food means the grass contain more cellulose. So it will be taken to the rumen. Rumen, I told you that whatever they are eating, they will be, the grass will be stored in a place that is known as the rumen. So inside the rumen, it contains some bacteria. Okay, the rumen contains some bacteria which will digest the food. Okay, which will digest the cellulose. So in the case of human beings, this bacteria is absent. So we cannot digest the cellulose. Okay. So when we are ingesting, we are removing our waste, the cellulose also will go from our body. But in the case of herbivores, these ruminant animals, they can digest this cellulose with the help of some bacteria present in the rumen. Okay, so this will be digested inside the rumen and it will be absorbed in the, and it will be absorbed. Okay, so this type of animals are known as the ruminants, and this type of this process, like the process of taking the food and again coming to the mouth, that is that process known as the rumination. I hope it is clear. Animals like horse and rabbit have some large sac like structure that is known as the cecum. Cecum is situated between the esophagus and small intestine, and it contains some bacteria which has the capacity to digest the cellulose. So once again we will see that. So animals like horses, rabbit have some large sac-like structure that is known as the cecum, C-A-E-C-U-M, that is situated between the esophagus and small intestine. So it contains some bacteria, the cecum contains some bacteria which is capable to digest the cellulose. So we cannot, like human beings, we cannot digest the cellulose, but the animals can, like cattle, deer, horse and rabbit, other animals, herbivores, especially herbivores, have the capacity to digest the cellulose. I hope it is clear to you.